Prasanna. And now the second presenter is Rian Ardiansyah. Please.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon or good early evening. My name is Rian Ardiansyah from Biology Department. And today I will be presenting my research. It's about the effect of learning based on web-enhanced course and web-centric course toward the students' learning outcomes in grade 11 for senior high school in Indonesia, and also especially for human reproduction system concept. And then I will write web-enhanced course with a WEC in the next slide, and also for web-centric course, I will write in WCC in the next slide. And let's see for the next slide. This is my background. My research discusses about the use of e-learning in an effort to improve the students' learning outcomes, especially for school, students in school. And you know that start from 2010 until 2012 and 13, the technological development is forcing some schools to use computer in e-learning activities. And for example, use e-learning. And in fact, in Indonesia, some schools in Indonesia are already use e-learning in their activities. But in fact, they are using e-learning with type of web-centric course. So what is web-centric course? Let's see. A web-centric course is a learning activities by using the internet and also by using the computer, where there are two sessions in these activities. For the first session, you can see face-to-face session, and second is online session. And for the face-to-face session, where the teacher explains the material in front of the class, or we can call it by traditional method, and also for the online session, where the students are required to access the web learning in their homes by using the private internet or public internet, or we can call it by baru internet in bahasa Indonesia, or warnet. And in fact, web-centric course also has some disadvantage and advantage. For example, for the advantage, in web-centric course, the students can learn anytime and anywhere in their home by using the internet, of course. And also, besides the advantage, the web-centric course also has some disadvantages. For example, web-centric course cannot touch affective aspect of students as teachers do in ordinary class. And also for the second disadvantage, for the students who cannot learn independently, they will get some problem when they must access the web learning in their home by themselves. Because in fact, in Indonesia, some schools in Indonesia cannot learn independently. And that's the reality, and that's the problem. So based on the previous problem, I try to give solution by developing a new model of e-learning so that next computer and internet become a learning media which is assisted by the teacher as a mentor in the classroom activities. So I call this new model as a web-enhanced course. Web-enhanced course is, it makes face-to-face session and online session is not separate again, but combined. So for the students who cannot learn independently, that can be helped by the teacher in the classroom. And also, we know that human reproduction system concept is an abstract concept that's very difficult to learn it. So hopefully, with the web-enhanced course, the students can learn human reproduction system concept with a variety of media in the internet, and also can be helped by the teacher, can be aided by the teacher, can be instructed by the teacher in the classroom in the learning activities. And this is for my method. The research method that I use is quasi-experimental with non-equivalent pre-test, post-test control design. Not control design, pre-test, post-test design. And there are two classes of experimental that I use. Each class consists about 30 students that's selected by purposive sampling. And for the first class, this is for the web-enhanced course class. And for second class, there is web-centric course class. Both of them are given the same pre-test and post-test. Both of them are given the same web learning, but different condition and different treatment. Let's see for the treatment. This is for the first class. First class, it means web-enhanced course class. In web-enhanced course class, the learning activities take place in the computer lab by using the internet. So the students were required and instructed to access the web learning by using the internet and computer lab. And also, and also can be aided by the teacher in the computer lab. So for the students who didn't understand about the concept that they found in the internet in the computer lab, they can ask questions directly to the teacher in the computer lab. And at the end of the lesson, the teacher can explain only some important concept in front of the students. That's for the first class. And for the second class, it means for the web-centric course class, the learning activities take place in the classroom as usual, where the teacher explains the material in front of the class by using the traditional method. And at the end of the lesson, the students were instructed to access the web learning in their homes by using their private internet or public internet. And for the students who didn't understand about the concept that they found in the internet in their homes, they can ask questions directly to the teacher by using the chat feature. Or they can ask the question in the next meeting in the classroom. That's for second class. And these students' learning outcomes achieved by using pre-test, post-test question at the beginning and the end of the lesson or treatment, by using multiple choice question, and also the recap of the students' learning outcome can be seen in the following table. Let's see for the recap. This is the recap of students' learning outcome. Let's see first for the pre-test. This is the pre-test. In the pre-test, for the both class, both of them have the same, not the same score. Both of them have the low score of pre-test. It means below the average of passing grade in that school, less than 65. Both of them less than 65. Why it can happen? Because the students didn't prepare about the concept before. It's normal. Why? Because it is pre-test, not post-test. In pre-test, sometimes students didn't prepare anything about the concept before. So they have a low pre-test score. And then I do normality and homogeneity test to determine the distribution of the data that I use in my research. And in the table, you can see that the data comes from the normally distributed population, and also based on the field test, the data is homogeneous. And also then I do the hypothesis test by using the Z-test. And it can be shown that Z calculated is less than Z table. So it means hypothesis 1 is rejected, so it can be concluded there is no significance difference between the pre-test for both class. And then, because there is no significant difference for both class in the pre-test, I do the hypothesis test for the post-test. And we can see that for the post-test, Z calculated is higher than Z table. So it can be concluded hypothesis 1 is accepted. So there is significance difference between the post-test for both class. And you can see for the score in the post-test, this is for the first class, the students who learned in the web-enhanced course have a higher score than the students who learned in the web-centric course. That's my result of the data. But of course, you have to remember that both of learning models still have some disadvantage and advantage. For example, for web-enhanced course class, the advantage is it makes the interaction between the student and the teachers is not reduced. Even bring up the interaction between the students and the other students in the learning activities. But still has a weaknesses for the web-enhanced course class. For example, some school in Indonesia didn't have a good internet connection for their lab computer. And also, some school in Indonesia didn't have a good condition for computer lab also. So, the conclusion for my research. So the students' learning outcomes, before being given treatment, there is no significant difference between the pre-test and the post class. And being after given the treatment, there is a significant difference between the post-test and the post class. And also students who learn with WEC, it means web-enhanced course class, has a higher score than students who learn in web-centric course class. That's my research. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, Diana Gersha.